Hi, parents. I'm Ms. Hodges. Good to see you. I want to welcome you to a flipped back to school night. Flipped meaning that you guys are doing the learning from home or on your device. And then when you come to me, you're going to get to have more like question and answer time, and you'll get to see around the room. I'm asking that your child come with you to back to school night so that way they can show you around. I'd like to let you know that there are four of us in fourth grade. However, your child will probably be with me most of the day. There aren't any cadres going on in our school anymore, and so they'll be with me for most of the day. And they might have another teacher for just the ELD portion, which is about 45 to 50 minutes a day. So it's not going to be very much if they do happen to have a different cadre teacher for English Language Development, which is ELD. I want to just share a little bit about myself. I did graduate from Fresno State, and then I went to National University for my master's degree. This is my sixth official year of teaching. Second year at Dr. Carrion. I've taught third grade and fourth grade in the past. And I moved to Coachella Valley in 2010, so I haven't been here my whole life. My husband is originally from here, so that's why we moved back here. He was in the Navy, and we moved around a lot. We lived in Spain before here, and as well as San Diego. And now we're here to stay. Some of my hobbies are that I like to swim, I like to travel, I do CrossFit, and I enjoy taking pictures, and I love to explore technology. We do a lot of technology in this class, as you'll soon see. And last year we got the privilege to be part of a program that from the district called the Goldfish Bowl, and we were awarded $4,000 that paid for some virtual reality technology that allows us to take virtual field trips in class. So that's something that our grade level shares and something that we get to do, and it's really special and exciting. So I'm excited to do that with our kids this year. We have school rules of the B rules, and which are be kind, be respectful, be safe, be responsible. And I really do kind of stick with those rules. But as a grade level two, we also have the whole brain rules, which the kids are used to: follow directions quickly, raise your hand, permission to speak, and those rules. But I will say that I typically will spend most of our time with like be kind, be respectful, be safe, be responsible. Basically, just trying to get them to be a good person. That's kind of my goal, and I hope it's your goal too. And so that's what we'll be working on throughout the school year. Tardy bell does ring at 8:30. So starting in fourth grade, school starts at 8:30 instead of 8:50. And so what we're asking is that parents drop off kids before that time. The first bell rings at 8:25, and so they are late, officially considered at 8:30. So what'll happen is that they start heading over to their line outside at 8:25, and they're in their spot in the line at 8:30. I go out there at 8:30. I have my device and I do attendance on my device, and I mark them absent if they're not there at that moment. We do have prep first thing, so if they come tardy, then they end up, I don't see them until after prep, and we'll talk about the schedule in a minute. If you need to clear the absence, so if they are absent for any reason, please clear it either through me or through the office. You can call them, you can email me. ClassJoJo is probably the easiest to e instead of emailing me, but you can also send me a note. Uniforms, we are either a light blue or burgundy tops and khaki bottoms. There's also some school club shirts that are okay to wear, as well as school shirts like the Keep Calm and Carry On, those kinds of shirts that are sold from the office. Our schedule, we have prep first thing. We have four preps, so we have our schedule. Let me think about it. I don't know if I remember all of them, but we have PE, library, music, and positive action, which is counseling. And so we have those four, and then Friday we don't have any prep. They come back to me, and they do math with me. And then we have recess. We have ELD, which is English Language Development. That's the only part of the day that they possibly might have a different teacher. And then they come back to me for reading language arts. And then we have lunch in between. And then we have science, class meeting, and then dismissal. Class meeting is something new I'm doing this year where students are leading the class meeting, and it's really great. It's a great time to reflect on our day, think about what went well, what are some things we can improve on, any announcements we might have, and then we get ready to line up and go home. It's really great. Thursdays are early dismissal days, so we get out at 1:45. Please don't forget that every Thursday, 1:45. Something else that's new this year is Avid is coming across the campus. Avid in fourth grade, Avid is happening across the entire grade level, and there's other grade levels too that are starting to get trained with it. It's a really great program. Middle school and high schools, they have this program as an elective where they are helping students get college ready. And so they help them get organized, teach them collaboration skills, and just teach them how to study for their classes. And so here at Dr. Carry On, we're going to be implementing it school-wide. This is our first year in that implementation plan. And so in fourth grade, we're going to be doing a lot of that, those types of skills too. But more information will be coming on that soon. Our core curriculum for language arts, which is reading language arts. I kind of, on this slide, I have a few things for you to see that in reading, what we're going to be working on, reading closely with text. And a lot of times we'll be reading something multiple times in class for different reasons. Like the first time might be just to get the main information. The second time might be closer look at, let's look at how this text is laid out on the page. And then the third read might be for more of a applying reason. We do read about half and half 50% informational text, so things that are about real topics, and 50% literature, like stories and that kind of stuff. Language still is embedded, though. We don't do a traditional spelling list that goes home and they have to practice and they have a spelling test. It's not assessed that way anymore. We do it in context, which I think is the better for learning, is that they're learning to correct, make corrections, and learning the proper spellings and learning things in context, like in real life. And when we're doing our normal reading and writing, that language is embedded and we're teaching those language skills there. In writing, we do teach three different types of writing, how to write an opinion, informational writing, and narrative writing, which are like stories. And we do practice with some performance tasks where we do some research, and then we do with multiple sources, multiple things to read, and then we end up doing a written project based on that. In math, we learned to add and subtract within 100,000. Multiplying basic facts was something that we did in third grade, but in fourth grade, we learn also how to do double digit times double digit. I'm going to ask that you be patient with us as we teach them these the double digit times double digit, because in fourth grade, we do teach them, we slow down and we teach them in a way that maybe you may not be used to. So I'm just going to ask that you be patient. The way that you may have been used to, and I know I was used to when I was in school, they'll be learning that eventually. I believe it's in sixth grade now, is that the traditional way to multiply double digit times double digit. So please don't teach them that yet. They'll get that eventually. Right now we're going to be doing baby steps and teaching them strategies. Same thing with division. There'll be a strategy they're going to be learning about this year that we don't want them to get too confused with the traditional way of, like, let's bring down the number with long division and that kind of stuff. So that's coming in sixth grade for them. So this year, let's just take it slow and let's get those strategies that we're learning down. We do fraction work. Last year, they did some fractions. This year, we build on that. Geometry, we do area, perimeter. Angles is a really fun unit that we do. We teaching angles, and we do some measurement. So math is one of my favorite things. You'll see. I already mentioned about preps a bit. We have science. We'll be starting science very soon. We haven't started it quite yet, but we'll be doing that. We'll be doing a science fair project, and that more information will be coming on that soon. This year, I'm trying a little different approach than last year. I know it became a headache for students last year when they had to do the science fair project at home. So I'm going to try something a little different and actually have them do it here in class. Wish me luck on that. Your grading that you'll see, I'm going to try to be on top of things with grading so that it'll be in the grade book. If you have the Parent View app, then you can see and be up to date with your students' grades throughout the school year. Usually tests are not every single week. Usually it's every other week or maybe 3 weeks. And then at the end of the school year, they're going to take that SBAC test, that CASP test again in May to kind of see what the growth that they did here in fourth grade. I have the grading scale there too, so you are aware of what we're looking for. Just so you know, we want them to add a 3 or above. I mean, 3 is the goal, that's where we want them mostly. If they're at a 4, great. That just kind of means that they're kind of above where we're looking at for our grade level. But 3 is that sweet spot. Oh, dang.
Are you dead?
No. I'm sorry. Bless you. Not quite. Okay. Let me try to speed it up here. Okay, homework. We have about